sit down. You guys can sit down. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Bristol Community College Nursing Class of 2016, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our honored guests, faculty, family, and friends. I am Audra Manchester, the Nursing Class President. At this time, I would like to introduce my fellow class officers. Rebecca D'Souza, Nursing Class Vice President. Anicia Matos, Nursing Class Treasurer. Jody Lynn Fisher-Rose, Nursing Class Secretary. Kathleen Rosanina, Nursing Class Dialogue Representative. Julie Eldridge, Nursing Class Dialogue Representative, eHealth. Amy Boner, Nursing Class Curriculum Representative. It is my privilege this evening to introduce our honored guests. I ask that you please stand when your name is called. Dr. John J. Spraga, President. Greg Sitharis, Vice President for Academic Affairs. Tafa Awolaju, Vice President for Human Resources and Affirmative Action. Sally Cameron, Vice President for College Communications. Rhonda Gabovich, Vice President for Institutional Research, Planning, and Assessment. Steve Kenyon, Vice President for Administration and Finance. Elizabeth McCarthy, Vice President for Resource Development. Steve Ozug, Vice President for Preparedness, Compliance, and Students. Joanne Pelletier, Vice President for Information Technology Services. Joan Maynard, Retired Vice President. Patricia Dent, Dean of Health Sciences. Lynn Broder, Associate Dean of Health Sciences. Donna Ayala, Nursing Department Chair and Associate Professor of Nursing. Members of the Vice President's Council, please stand as your name is called. Anthony Ucci, Associate Vice President of Academic Affairs. Anna Galat, Associate Vice President of Academic Affairs. Rodney Clark, Dean of the Attleboro Campus. Gloria Sadler, Director of Taunton Center. James Daniel, Dean of New Bedford Campus. Sarah Morrell, Dean of Access and Transition. William Berardi, Dean of Business and Information Management. Kathleen Pearl, Dean of Behavior and Social Sciences. Uli Ryder, Dean of Humanities and Education. Sarmad Saman, Dean of Mathematics, Science, and Engineering. Suzanne Buglione, Dean of Lash Division for Teaching and Learning. Deborah Cohen, Dean of Advising. April Bellafiore, Dean of E-Learning. Our full-time nursing faculty, please stand as your name is called, and I ask that you hold applause until everyone's name has been called. Stephen Alves. Dr. Kathleen Plant. Deborah Quenga. Nancy Moxon. Renee Cardinal. Patricia Shriver. Donna Muncy, Melaine Perenzino, Mickey Pike, Jacqueline Shook, Kathleen Pilot, Geraldine Hamill. Our adjunct faculty, Vivian Demers, Kimberly Aguiar, Diane LeClaire, Deborah Levesque, Joan McCarthy, Kathy Annenson, Sandra Waters, Lucille Force, Joyce Contois, Brian Costa, Stephanie DeRosiers. Thank you all for your dedication and guidance over these last 2 years. Our opening invocation will now be delivered by Renee Cardinal. Would everyone please stand?
Welcome, everyone. We're here today to show our appreciation for the BCC nursing graduates. They should feel pride in having completed their rigorous course of study. Family and friends may have heard a word or two regarding this rigorous course of study. Being in a place outside one's comfort zone can be painful and anxiety-provoking, but with any growth spurt, this is to be expected. Think back to the beginning of the program. Think how much you've learned, how much you've grown. You've held the academic bar high and you've catapulted over it. In the words of Helen Keller, character cannot be developed in ease and quiet. Only through experience of trial and suffering can the soul be strengthened, ambition inspired, and success achieved. We recognize and appreciate the sacrifices that have been made by you and loved ones to reach this purposeful goal. Tonight, as we celebrate your entrance into the nursing profession, we pass the eternal flame from Florence Nightingale on to you, as we have had it passed on to us. This wonderful profession applies the arts and sciences. Each is as important as the other. Like many scientists, we rely on our knowledge, analysis, application, and evaluation of data of patients in the workplace. But who only wants a scientist by the bedside? We want someone who is well-rounded, someone who combines the sciences with the arts. The arts including caring, empathy, understanding, and providing comfort. These concepts are not easily taught in the classroom. Much of the arts come from the emotions from our life experiences. In nursing, you'll get a lot of these life experiences in every phase of the human condition. You will enter the inner sanctum of the lives of your patients. You will know more about your patients and their experiences than many of their own family members. But keep in mind, it is about their experiences and not yours. Know your baggage, pack it away, and care for your patients and their loved ones like they will remember your interaction forever. Keep this in mind if someday you may silently need to sit and hold the hand of a 95-year-old woman who has outlived every family member and friend she's ever cared for and no longer wishes to deal with the pains of living anymore. Or knowing that there is an optimal time to bond with your newborn, you may need to gently encourage a new mother to hold her newborn after the shock of being told that her, quote, perfect child that she has anticipated for 9 months has severe disabilities. Or you may see yourself in the position of consoling the young family of an 11-year-old who has lost his battle with cystic fibrosis when his transplanted lungs were rejected. Handle these experiences with care and empathy, because though you may or may not forget these experiences, these families certainly will not. They will remember the very emotional occasion that brought them to seek medical care, and they will remember you. In conclusion, I leave you with another quote from my girl, Helen Keller. Many persons have a wrong idea of what constitutes true happiness. It's not attained through self-gratification, but through fidelity to a worthy purpose. And what a worthy purpose you have chosen, and thank you for choosing to become a nurse. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Cardinal. It is now my honor to introduce President John Spraga.
Well, good evening, everyone. What a wonderful event this is in the annual year at Bristol Community College. I want to begin by offering our collective congratulations to our graduates. Well done, and we're very proud of you. Great work. Thank you. On your behalf, I would like to thank the faculty and staff who pushed you and prodded you and pulled you and made sure that you completed this program successfully. I always tell the graduates it's easy. It's harder a program to get into, but it's very hard to get out successfully. You did a great job. And also on your behalf, I'd like to thank your family and loved ones and friends who supported you, the network that helped you as you went through the very difficult travails that goes with the curriculum in nursing. And I know you would feel that way about them as well. And I will extend my thanks to you, parents and guardians and supporters and loved ones and everybody who helped these graduates. I just want to quickly mention to the graduates that we're very proud of, we're very proud of them, but we're very proud also of the role modeling that they have done. And things that they didn't even know they were doing. They didn't do it for this reason. But our students, our other students at the college, saw you asking for extra lab time or asking for work study or study areas to work in. That rubbed off on our other students. And no matter, you never know who and where and all the different programs that we have at the college. So I thank you for setting a great model. You also set a great model for your friends and neighbors and people you didn't even know probably down the street who watched you come through snow and rain and everything else, nice beach days, and still go with your books under your arm and to continue your studies. And that rubs off on people as well, to watch you as you march through the very difficult curriculum. And finally, I think that we have little ones here, and they will never forget this night. You have set a great example for them, and we want to set the tone and culture of education where they will keep up the cycle that you've created. Okay, sound good? You're members of our BCC family. You're always welcome back. If we can provide some help to you, please feel that you belong here. And as I say, you're part of the BCC family forever now. You can't get rid of us, okay? So congratulations, I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, President Spraga. We will now hear a few words from Greg Satharis, Vice President of Academic Affairs.
Welcome everyone this evening, and congratulations to all the graduates. This is a phenomenal evening for you. Oftentimes at this time of year, a week from Saturday, we're going to be at our commencement exercises, our graduation for these students who are sitting up on stage. And oftentimes at this time of year, people, at least one person, and I guarantee three, four, or five, will reference how this is not necessarily a graduation, but a commencement. And for this group of students sitting on stage, there is no better way to describe any group of graduating students this year other than our nursing students. This year, this spring 2016 graduating class is commencing in a variety of ways that they're going to continue to need your support along the way. They're commencing not only into their career as a professional nurse, for which they are uniquely qualified to do that work, but they also be commencing into a life of learning and a life of professional development that is going to include more education, and they are going to need even more love and support from everybody in this audience tonight over the next several years. Sorry to say that, but I think you know it already. And I can guarantee that many of the students sitting behind me are already enrolled in a bachelor's program, and I can also guarantee you that some of them are already enrolled in a master's degree program. I can also tell you that many of them are going to go on practice in nursing in our region, will go on to even further their education into Doctor of Nursing Practice programs, and I certainly know and I hope that many of them will choose the field of education, of nursing education, and will go on and complete their PhD in nursing. These are the nursing leaders of the future, and I congratulate you all, and I want to make sure over the next week and a half that you give lots of hugs to everybody who's out in the audience, because they deserve it for all of the support that they have given you. So thank you. Make sure to continue to give our graduates, our people who are commencing to that next stage of their life, all of the love and support that you can, because they're gonna need it and our society needs them. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vice President Sitharis. We will now hear from the Dean of Health Sciences, Patricia Dent.
Good evening, everyone, and especially to the graduates of the BCC Nursing Program Class of 2016. On behalf of Associate Dean Broder and myself, it is wonderful to be here at this pinning ceremony and to congratulate this wonderful nursing class. Tonight really is all about you and a night to celebrate. You have been guided and mentored by a faculty whose care, compassion, and expertise are the foundational core of the nursing profession. Greeting you as you began this journey with all that paperwork was Charlotte, who has been there to help you and our faculty throughout the program. Graduates, take a look out into this audience. All the family, friends, and faculty, they're behind you, but behind you too, that have supported you, and they're here to celebrate with you. Through the support of our administration, Board of Trustees, and the BCC Foundation, we have laboratories and equipment that prepare students to be competent nursing healthcare professionals. I think they all deserve a round of applause. Each year, I have the privilege of speaking to our nursing graduates. My reflections tonight will be brief, but they are from my heart. First, let me say that I truly love nurses, and I am fortunate to work with and have met some truly remarkable nurses. Why are they so remarkable? How and why do these nurses stand out for me? They truly are professionals who advocate for their patients. They care about respect and the dignity of those they treat. They are people of integrity and values. They love what they do and are committed to advancing nursing. They are gifted, they are ethical, and they are so much more. And here it is. They truly listen to the question. the question behind the question, and the question that the patient is too afraid to ask. Let me give you an example. A patient arrives for a new treatment procedure and is very anxious. You are the nurse. He asks the following question: how long have you worked in this area and been doing this? What is the question? Is it really the number of weeks or years the nurse has worked there? Or is it something else? Is the question really more about what the patient needs to know to feel safe and know that he is in the hands of a competent, caring nurse? What would your response be? You have been given a special privilege, for you are entrusted with the care of someone's mother, father, brother, sister, son, daughter, or best friend. The value of your care, your words, and your touch in bringing healing will be immeasurable. In those moments that you reach out to touch, reassure, and be fully present, you will give your patient the courage to take the next step toward wellness. Listen to your patient's questions, asked and unasked, and most importantly, listen to their soul. May you always keep growing and find joy in your service to others. Have a great journey and congratulations.
Thank you, Dean Dent. Now we will hear from Nursing Department Chair Donna Ayala.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome. Before I get going, I just want to thank the class officers who had started this process 2 years ago. And we always talk about the rigor of the program, and to do this additional fundraising and organization, and really the leadership role to get this day completed. And it's always so lovely. So if we can give them a round of applause. Also, we have a wonderful group of advisors for the pinning ceremony, the faculty that are listed here, Deb and Kathy and Nancy Moxon, who chairs it, and so many of the other faculty, Patty Shriver and Steve Alves joined this year, and I just want to thank them also, because it was outside their role description. I think they always go above and beyond to try to make sure that we take care of our own. So it's with a grateful heart that I'm here today, thanking you for your support, and to thank the people that are here. The president has always been a wonderful support of the nursing program. He called us the gem of the college during our accreditation. I'll never forget that, so I try to polish myself once in a while so we shine so brightly. So that's really wonderful to hear when you have that kind of support. The Board of Trustees, of course, also a big part of the external stakeholders that take a look at what we need, and healthcare is always a big important issue, and the college is striving towards improving those kinds of things and getting ready for the community in those ways, so that's always important. The President's Council gives us support, as does the Vice President's Council, so I thank you for your time, and it's always awesome to have you here and being part of this process here, because it really takes the whole college to create these wonderful people here, and they are wonderful, and that's what it's all about. We have a curriculum that's rigorous, and I had the opportunity to actually spend some time with each of them in a lab setting. And that's really great because I don't oftentimes have that role. I'm usually behind a desk and it's like the bad guy and the good guy, the bad guy. And then, but this time I got to see them at their best, and that, and their brains are so amazing, and their sentiment that is with them just inspires me, because whether they know it or not, they've already inspired. They inspire us every day, and the reason why we do this over and over again is because we have the hope. This is the hope. The hope of the community is right here, because you'll never know it, you're different when you're facing your mortality. If any of you have been sick or know people that are ill, it is the most vulnerable time of your life, and the nurse makes a difference. And of course, it's a multidiscipline, we know that. But at the end of the day, when someone can be open and present and be completely engaged, you can have effect that transcends words. I can't even put it in words. So you have a lot of beauty awaiting you in your career. You're going to see how amazing nursing is. And I just thank you for choosing BCC. I hope I didn't forget anyone. Oh, the faculty, who I love. I didn't say thank you to them. And I'm sure, I just want to thank you for all the hard work. And it's been a pleasure to see you develop. And I can't wait to see what you do for the nursing world and for the community. And I expect big things, because you already did big things. So congratulations, class of 2016.
Thank you, Professor Ayala. At this time, I invite Dr. Kathleen Plant to conduct our scholarship presentations.
Good evening, everyone. I have the honor of presenting 20 students with a scholarship this evening. The first scholarship is the Donna M. Castro Memorial Nursing Scholarship, and the first recipient is Lindsay Cadero. The second recipient is Nicholas Satola. The third recipient of this scholarship is Priscilla Pont. Fourth recipient is Jamie Webb.
Jamie? No? Jamie's not here?
Okay. And also Anna Abdelkader is also a recipient of this scholarship, and I'll make sure that they both get these. The next scholarship is awarded to a student who demonstrates academic promise. And this scholarship, in the name of Christopher J. Dickey, is awarded to Jessica Louise. The next scholarship is an annual award to a BCC nursing student entering their second year and who demonstrates academic promise. It is the August I. Ryer PhD Memorial Scholarship, and that scholarship is awarded to Mercy Adebongankeng. The next scholarship is going to be awarded by a faculty member, Professor Patricia Shriver.
Good evening, everyone. I'm very honored to present this scholarship tonight. I've always felt that whenever there's a tribute to someone, it's important that their story be told so that their memory isn't lost to just a name on a monetary gift. Evelyn Pacheco was an amazing woman and nurse. I know this firsthand because she was my mom. Today is her birthday, and she's been gone for 31 years now, and that's a long time. Some of these graduates behind me weren't even born then. But she lived for 60 years, so I'd like to just take a couple of minutes to tell you about how she lived. For 34 years, she worked at a small community acute care hospital in Middleborough. Some of you may still know of it. It's reopened recently as a psychiatric hospital. This was our community hospital, and Evelyn Pacheco was an icon for that hospital. Now, can you imagine, in this day and age, anyone being considered an icon for a hospital? They're too big now, and they're big business. But she truly was. For 34 years, she had a larger-than-life presence there. Why? Because she was a consummate professional nurse. She was immaculate. She always dressed, well, the way that these nurses here are dressed tonight, all in white with her nursing cap and her white stockings and her immaculate white shoes. But more than that, she was hardworking and she was compassionate and she was caring. And it was these very traits that endeared her to such an enormous community. She truly cared about the people. I had the opportunity to work with her for her when I was a teenager as a ward secretary. And I got to see how truly magnanimous she was. She consistently touched people's lives professionally, personally, compassionately, and generously. Evelyn Pacheco was the kind of nurse that didn't just show up for work and put her time in. She gave so much of herself to her community. She often delivered babies because she was there and the doctors weren't. She sat with families when they were at their most vulnerable. She many times gave up her breaks so that her nurses, who much needed those breaks, would have them. And she was often found in the pediatric ward playing with the kids. Every year, I remember she anonymously gave out money at Christmas time for nurses that worked for her that she knew that was struggling. She anonymously gave money to nurses who wanted to further their education. She supported their flexible scheduling and anything that she could to assist their schooling because she knew that education was so important. She exemplified what real nursing stands for: professionalism, education, caring, trust, and compassion. Her community did not and has not still ever forgotten this. They started a scholarship fund that has been helping nursing students, myself included, now for over 30 years. 20 years now, this year at BCC. Because one woman made such a difference in so many lives, this scholarship honors her and continues to help nursing students each year. This year, I am honored to present this award to Cheyenne Rigo.
The next scholarship goes to two students. The scholarship is the John A. and Eileen F. Carr and Catherine V. Whalen Scholarship. This goes to two students who show academic excellence and achievement. The first student is Tracy Cooley. The second student to receive this scholarship is Rachel Baxter. The next scholarship is the Lucy Rose Memorial Nursing Scholarship and goes to a student who demonstrates scholastic merit. And this student is Alyssa DeMello. The next scholarship is an annual award that is given to a BCC nursing student entering their second year and who also demonstrates academic achievement. It is the Marguerite G. Condon Memorial Nursing Scholarship, and the recipient is Serena Gunderson. The next scholarship is presented to two students who demonstrate academic achievement and academic excellence. The Marie B. Maloof Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Raffaele D'Souza. The next recipient of this scholarship is Jessica Henriques. The next scholarship is the Mullins Family Nursing Scholarship, and we have the honor to have Mr. James Mullin here to present the scholarship and say a few words.
Glad to be here to present this scholarship. I want to say to these nurses, they have a marvelous future for them. You can, years ago, when you retired, when you became a nurse, you either worked in a St. Anne's or Truesdale or one of the local hospitals. The world has changed so much. The world is your oyster. You get the RN and you get a Massachusetts degree, you're welcome in any hospital, any place in the world, not just United States. And I would just like to say that one place where they're looking for nurses is in the armed forces. I come from a family with three nurses, and I have a daughter who's a nurse. And one of my sisters went into the Air Force. My father, who was a retired chief, almost had apoplexy when she told him she was going to go to the Air Force. But she lived all over the world. They lived in Greece. They lived in London. They lived in Germany, and she had a wonderful career. And then in the end, when she finished her career, she ended up with a lieutenant colonel on her arm and five kids behind her. Thank you.
And Mr. Mullins will present the scholarship to Katrina Simmons.
Oh, here she is.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
This next scholarship goes to a nursing student who is graduating in their second year. This student demonstrates outstanding clinical skills. It is the Union Hospital School of Nursing Alumni Association Scholarship, and this scholarship is awarded to Rebecca D'Souza. Did you know? The next scholarship is the Truesdale Hospital Nurses Alumni Association Scholarship, and I have Mrs. Nancy Whitlock here on the stage to help me present this scholarship. The student who is the recipient of this scholarship demonstrates scholastic and clinical competence, and this student is Joshua True. The next scholarship is the Marie Marshall Nursing Scholarship. I'd like to acknowledge Dr. Marie Marshall if she's in the audience. Where is she? Oh, there she is. This scholarship is given to a student who demonstrates scholastic merit, and the student is Evelyn Vega. The last scholarship is a surprise. This student was chosen by the second year faculty and is awarded to a student who demonstrates superior clinical competence. It is the Ruth E. Hurley Nursing Award Scholarship, and the graduating student is Jamie Gillette. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Plant. Good evening, faculty and staff, family and friends. Tonight has been a long-awaited event for every member of this class. It is the culmination of 2+ years of dedication, sacrifice, self-discovery, and now celebration. I can say without any doubt that this is one of, if not the biggest accomplishment for all of us that sit before you today. That being said, it was more than just hard work that brought us to this point. One quality we all possess is that we have courage to face new and unfamiliar experiences. We had the courage to take the necessary steps toward achieving our goal of becoming a registered nurse. From enrolling in our first A&P class to stepping into a clinical setting for the first time, we have all felt nervous and apprehensive of this process at one time or another. We have had the courage to step out of our comfort zone, to make sacrifices, and to learn to find security in the idea that our goal was close within reach. In the 2 years that we have been in this program, life has not slowed down for any one of us. But with the support of family and friends, and also faculty, each obstacle we have faced along the way is now a distant bump in the road. And as we prepare to take our boards, find employment, and further pursue our education, we are right back to where we started, staring a new experience straight in the face. And we will all succeed gracefully because completing the BCC nursing program is not for the faint of heart. It is for those who are all heart. In closing, I would like to thank our family and friends and faculty who have supported us on this journey, and also, and especially, my fellow class officers who put in countless hours of fundraising and planning so that we could all be honored here tonight. Thank you. At this time, we invite Professors Donna Ayala, Nancy Moxon, and Stephen Alves to conduct our pinning.
It is my honor to present the nursing class of 2016. Audra J. Manchester. Rebecca M. D'Souza. Anicia C. Matos. Jody Lynn Fisher Rose. Kathleen Rosonina. Julie Eldridge. Amy E. Boner. Yvonne Abad. Mandy Abrentes. Barbara Ahegan. Shannon Andrade. Macy Andre. Sonia Andre. Melissa Andrioli. Stephanie Aniki. Melissa Aruda. Bonnie Baird. Tanya Blake. Sarah Borden. Sonia Blake, Sonia Braga, excuse me. Alexa Boutlier. Stacy Bucci. Raquel Cabral. Kelsey Cardozo. Kelly Carrico. Susan Carter. Nicole Crowder. Anna Cueva Marino. Heather Dacey. Cynthia Dara. Elizabeth DeMello. Katie DeJalet. Antonio Dias. Jessica Dias. Amanda Eldridge. Kimberly Ferreira. Sonia Ferreira. Alyssa Gonzalez. Carrie Gould. Kristen Goodminson. Jamie Gallette. Kristen Habershaw. Amanda Harrington. Jessica Iamele. Carlton George. Linda Kelleher. Megan Kelly. Susan Lacey. Charlotte Ann Leary. Melinda Lindo. Casey Lyonnaise. Stephanie Machado. Desiree McGuire. Kelly Matos. Kelly. Lisa McCormick. Diane McDonald. Finesse Medeiros. Jennifer Medeiros. Rebecca Medeiros. Danielle Mello. Teresa Mello. Eugenia Montero. Andrea Neves. Stephanie Nichols. Vanessa Noguera. Elise Willette. Laura Paveo. Sarah Prokowski. Patricia Petris. Jessica Pimentel. Brianne Robinette. Jay Rulier. Amanda Senna. Rebecca Smith. Stephanie Valente. Caitlin Villanueva. Kelsey Voisin. Leanna Westgate. Nana Willard. Andrea Xavier. Congratulations to the class of 2016.
Our class secretary, Jody Lynn Fisher-Rose, will now deliver a message to our family and friends.
Good evening. On behalf of the nursing class of 2016, I would like to thank our greatest supporters, our family and friends. You are sitting in this audience tonight because you believed in us. You helped us achieve our dream, and we will forever be thankful. Throughout our journey in the most rigorous program that Bristol Community College has to offer, you stood by us. Every individual on this stage tonight has a different story. Some entered this program fresh out of high school and needed the focus and encouragement that only a parent and family could provide. Others have a family of their own and juggled family, work, and school. We have all sacrificed many family functions, children's school functions, and other life events due to our clinical rotations and long hours studying. Many times, we couldn't even sit down and enjoy the company of our family. But trust and believe that it was because of your support and encouragement that we could achieve our dreams. It may have seemed as though we took your love and support for granted throughout our journey, but it is just the opposite. Because without you, we would not be sitting here tonight, having made our way to the most honest and ethical profession in America, without you. So with our deepest thanks and appreciation, especially to our significant others, family, spouses, and children, we thank you and love you, and we will continue to make you proud. I will leave you tonight with a quote from Florence Nightingale. I think one's feelings waste themselves in words. They ought all to be stilled into actions which bring results. And I thank you again for helping bring those results.
Thank you, Jody. I now ask that our class vice president, Rebecca D'Souza, deliver a message to graduates.
As I address you all today, I want you to think back to the very moment when you received your letter of acceptance to the BCC nursing program, and to think that almost 2 years ago, each one of us began on this incredible endeavor. Some of us coming into the program as friends, others as complete strangers to one another. Although time passed, we helped each other along the way and gained friendships, which helped us bond as a nursing family. Because each one of us knew that we all were striving for this very moment. You can ask any one of us, and they'll probably tell you that these two past years have definitely not been easy. But I can guarantee that they will say that it has been the most rewarding. Tonight we gather one last time to commemorate our success. Moving forward from this day, we will remember the tears, the laughs, the long nights spent studying, friendships, all the hard work, sacrifice, and dedication that we put into this program. But at least we can let out a sigh of relief as the feeling of accomplishment can now set in, because right now we know that we indeed have made it. I would like to wish all of my fellow graduates the best of luck on whichever path they may choose to travel. May you always succeed in your future goals. I want to take this moment to tell you guys to congratulate one another, because we have worked extremely hard. Congratulate one another. Thank you for an amazing 2 years.
Thank you, Becca. Our class treasurer, Anicia Matos, will now deliver a message to the faculty.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. As we all sit before you today on this stage as nurses, we must also recognize the nurses who have been with us since our very first day in this program. our professors. It takes a kind and patient individual to work with students. As they must know, students sometimes aren't always the easiest to handle. They provided the education and support for us to become who we are today. Our journey here at Bristol Community College has ended, but you have instilled a lifetime of knowledge into each one of us. The countless hours of studying and pushing ourselves towards this goal has made us all become the best nurse who doesn't give up on their patients' care because they never gave up on themselves. Each one of us has been inspired by at least one, if not many, of our professors. Our first year faculty took a college student and molded us into that student nurse role. While learning the basics of nursing, each task was practiced until it was instilled in us. Our first year professors molded us to what was the right way to do things. We learned so much about not only how to care for our patients, but in our own self, in who we wanted to become. Countless times they reminded us to be the nurse that you want to be. Thank you, first year faculty, for opening up the opportunity and showing us what nursing truly is and encouraging us to never give up. To our second year faculty, these individuals expected nothing but the best. Throughout the year, they molded and further educated the student nurse into the graduate nurse you see on this stage today. A nurse who is ready to leave their side with competency and confidence. If something didn't make sense, we researched. If our judgment on a patient's status seemed different than baseline, we assessed. Things that seemed so hard to grasp when we first started have become so natural because of them. Thank you, second year faculty, for reminding us that we are ready for this journey to end and for our next one to begin. Nursing school is no easy task to complete, but for the students before you today, it is now in their past. I hope that we make you proud and continue day to day living the lessons each one of you has taught us. I leave with a quote from Pelé. Success is no accident. It is hard work, perseverance, learning, studying, sacrifice, and most of all, love of what you are doing or learning to do. Thank you.
Thank you, Anicia. At this time, we would like to recognize a few faculty and staff who have been especially helpful and kind in both our academic journey and in planning for this pinning ceremony. Please come to the stage when I call your name. Donna Ayala. Dr. Kathleen Plant. Nancy Moxon. Patricia Shriver. Deborah Quenga. Mickey Pike. Jacqueline Shook. Charlotte Medeiros. Roxanne Ramos. Okay. She's not here. Let me just leave it there. Now, Professors Deborah Cuenga and Patricia Shriver will lead us in our candlelight pledge.
I pledge myself in the presence of this assembly to practice my profession faithfully. I will devote myself to the welfare of those entrusted in my care, considering each individual as deserving my respect, dignity, and the best care I can give. I will hold in my confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping and all family affairs coming to my knowledge in my practice. I will never knowingly misuse or discredit my profession, but always endeavor to elevate its standards.
Thank you. Donna Muncy will now honor us with a benediction.
Good evening. I am honored and humbled to stand before you in the position traditionally occupied by Professor Anna Strakoff, who embodied the unshakable dedication that motivates all of the assembled faculty here on this very special evening. Graduates, can you feel the spirit here tonight?
Yes, absolutely.
It's the same spirit that brought you to your successful completion of this leg of your professional journey. The spirit of caring, compassion, and commitment that led you to become a nurse. The spirit of determination, integrity, and sacrifice that led you to successfully finish this chapter in your budding educational story. The spirit of altruistic ambition, humble self-confidence, and love of humanity that now leads you on to even greater things in the practice of your adopted profession. It's that spirit that will continue to make it possible to accomplish, give, and persevere beyond your own limited capacities. It therefore must have as its source something far greater than ourselves and a purpose far higher than our own personal goals. That spirit is the divine, to whom we now appeal for special blessings as you set out tonight on a very meaningful and sacred journey. We invoke the blessing of gratitude for Bristol Community College, for the tireless efforts of President Spraga, Vice President Sitharis, Dean Dent, Nursing Program Director Donna Ayala, and for all of the dedicated administrators and faculty who strive on a daily basis to fulfill the mission of Bristol Community College. And for the priceless support and significant sacrifice of friends and family, without which the fulfillment of this dream would not have been possible. We invoke the blessing of inspired aspiration to have the courage to dream big and to push ourselves beyond our comfort zone, to have a vision of an even greater future to pursue, and to have the fortitude to overcome the inevitable hardships that life puts between us and the goals we set. Lastly, and especially, we invoke the blessing of life's most essential entities, that of faith to overcome doubt, that of hope to overcome discouragement, and that of love to overcome suffering and to sustain a spirit of selfless giving. Bristol Community College Nursing Graduates 2016, you've lit the lamp. Now let it shine for all the world to see.
Thank you, Professor Muncy. This fall, the nursing department lost a dear member of their faculty, Professor Anna Strakoff. I would like to honor her memory by reciting a poem she had written. A person struggles in life, offers opportunity. This opportunity begins to develop and sculpture a design. This design evolves into a masterpiece. This masterpiece will impact many. Many will receive humanity by its effect. The key is to diffuse the toxins, to overcome the barriers, barriers that often stop or hinder the pieces, in order for this masterpiece to be fully developed and to make decisions toward mankind. This concludes our pinning ceremony. Please join us for refreshments in the lobby, and thank you all for being here.